Mrs. Menon, please be on stage. I request you to be chair itself to be here. We start the evening with Gopika's chanting. It's Saundarya Lahari by Adi Shankaracharya and it is for Divine Mother. Please Gopika, you may start.
Thank you.
request everyone to stand up and observe a minute silence. Given those cards, please share your fond moments, please share your feelings for her. I request, yes. First, I will request Sarayu Ben, curator of NGMA, an art historian, and above all, college buddy of Prafulla Ma'am. Prafulla Ma'am would fondly say that in her college days, they were termed, nicknamed as Ganga Jamuna. I'll call her. Please come up on stage.
Thank you. We are all gathered here today on a very sad occasion. And it is particularly sad for me. Sad. May I also request you all to put your formula silent. What can I say? With what words can I describe the emptiness that I feel with Prafulla's passing away? And that too, rather suddenly, because the last time I saw her, which was not really very long ago, about 15 days ago, she was in bed. I went there at about 6 o'clock in the evening and she was chatting with me. She was chatting on the phone and we were discussing things. She was joking with me, you know, when I commented that she'd become rather thin. She said, well, you know, one has become thin at a time when one needn't have become thin. You know, when we were young and wanted to be slim, that would have been different. So she was in a jocular mood. She seemed all right. I sat with her and then at about 7:30, when she would like to see her serials, I left. So when I, a few days later, when I heard that she wasn't well, I was quite unprepared for what I heard. I heard that she had been moved to the hospital and that she was on life support. It was such a different situation from what I had seen of it a few days ago, and it worried me tremendously. And then I found out that she was really quite serious and they were not expecting her to be able to come out of it. Later I was told by her daughter that she was in great pain and that she had decided that enough. I have lived a full life and everything is enough and I just want to go. And she mirrored herself and the life force just ebbed away. It is so difficult of Prafulla, you know, when she made up her mind about something, she was able to do it. For me, it is a great loss. Because Prafulla and I have known each other for many, many years. At first, our meeting was also so typical of what Prafulla stands for. I had joined the JJ School of Art and at the Fine Arts building on the steps, I met Prafulla. And you know, she immediately, very effusively and very enthusiastically started talking to me. And For me as a newcomer, it was such a wonderful feeling to be accepted. And at that time, she was a senior and she was a well-known personality in the college. So to be accepted and taken in hand by a senior person was such a wonderful thing. You see, I had finished my graduation at Fairfaxton College and come there. So while we were more or less of the same age, she was a senior and I was a junior at the School of Art. So she really made my life so pleasant in the School of Art. In the 2 years I was there, she was constantly mentoring me, constantly helping me, and we became very close friends. And thereafter, I mean, for now almost 60 years, we have been very good friends, and we have been together in numerous, expeditions together, numerous projects together, numerous things together. She not only became a friend, my friend, but she became a friend of our families, and that was the quality that Prafulla had. She just did not make friends with one person, she made friends with everyone around her, and somehow she had the ability to draw people towards her. She had that magnetism, you know, her effusiveness, her generosity, her spontaneity, everything brought people towards her. And that way she had an ever-larging, ever-expanding circle of friends. And whenever one wanted anything, she'd say, yes, yes, I know so-and-so, I'll get this done for you, I'll do that. She was always so forthcoming in these matters. She has been known for her quality of giving, of being very, very generous, of being very helpful, of helping people whom she did not even know. I remember times when I was with her at this art gallery and we would be looking at exhibitions and we would meet young artists who had come all the way from distant places. They would be here and they would be wanting, you know, they may not have sold very much, they had lots of expenses. So Prafulla would sit there, you know, and call up collectors and say, here is a nice, here's a good artist, very accomplished work, if you would like, please come, see and purchase. You know, her last word was also, purchase the work of this artist and help them. And many an artist she has helped that way. I have seen her do it and I have always admired this quality in her, to be able to give so much. And while giving, she was also very, very frank with her opinions, very forthright, you know. She would speak her mind to anyone, regardless who the person may be, whether it was a young artist or it was a person like Hussein, a man of stature and fame. She would openly say what she wanted. And the strange thing is, nobody ever minded it. I have seen her talking like that with Mr. J.J. Bhabha of the National Center of Performing Arts. I've also seen her giving her opinion to Mrs. Sarla Birla, the wife of Mr. B.K. Birla, regarding her connection. So she was free with her opinion, she was free with what she felt, and she always conveyed it. But what was strange was that nobody minded it. Actually, she endeared herself to them because they felt, here is a person who is transparent, who is saying what she feels and who is saying it openly without any axe to grind. I mean, there are very few people like that, and that quality of hers just was amazing. I mean, we all think twice about voicing our opinion, not Prafulla, and we all liked that. And her ability to give herself in various ways. I recall when I was at Marg, as editor of Marg, I was doing the volume on Goa. And, you know, I didn't know Goa very well. I didn't know all the art forms there. She said to me, why are you worried? I'll take you there. Together she came with me, we went to Goa, she opened all doors for me, I was able to see many things, I was able to photograph many things, I had entry into old mansions, I could photograph some of their, heritage properties, I could photograph their artifacts, and my volume became very interesting because of that. But were it not for Prafulla, I would not have been able to do it with such ease and comfort as I did. So for a person to be like that, and as I said, I have experienced her generosity in many ways, and she would take me to places, you have to buy good saris, they are available here, there is some good jewelry available here because of our common interests and the many things we did together. These are the sort of things where she would, you know, openly, open sources. Many people, you know, are very, very guarded about their sources. They don't give generously. But Prafulla was always very, very generous in whatever she did. When I met Prafulla, she was, as I said, she was a senior and she was passing out. She was winning so many awards and she had such a promising career ahead of her. She was really winning awards at the Bombay Heart Society, at various other institutions, and her portraits were excellent. But over the years, you know, her interest shifted. From painting, she went into institution building. She began to take a deep interest in the Bombay Art Society, in the Artist Center, and the Art Society of India. She somehow felt that these institutions, in the new sort of way in which the art world was functioning, were perhaps becoming irrelevant. And to her, that was not something that she liked. She wanted to make them relevant. She wanted them to have their glory. She wanted to restore them to their prime position again. And she spent a lot of time. I remember since 88 or even before that, she was the prime mover in Bombay Art Society. She urged me to get land from Sharad Pawar for Bombay Art Society. Had it not been for Prafulla, I would have never approached him. And I think it would never have transpired that Bombay Art Society got this wonderful piece of land in the Bandra Kurla complex, right across from the Leelavati Hospital. So it's a very good location, and she managed to get it. Then for many years, the plot remained empty because they were not able to collect funds to build a building. But she never gave up. She went to various persons, she talked to different people, she went to government agencies, she saw that the plot was not taken away, and then she was able to find someone who funded the building, and that building is today ready. I am so happy that Prafulla could see the building ready and in place before she passed away. Now, today, it is up to the artists of Bombay to see that that institution functions, that it functions in the way she had envisaged, and that it functions well and is restored to its former glory. Today, we have gathered here to praise and celebrate the life of a person who gave so generously and so bountifully to everyone, and we hope. And she has, in that way, contributed significantly to the art scene. And we hope we will always remember her in that way, and we will keep her memory alive in various ways. Thank you.
New madam, from 1959 onwards, I request Mr. Vinayak Hedekarji.
Namaskar. अभद्र अशुभाचा जरा सुद्धा वारा लागू न देणाऱ्या मानसिकतेत काम करणाऱ्या प्रफुल्लताई. प्रफुल्ला ताई असं हे मराठीत बरोबर असतं, पण आमच्या पुरतं प्रफुल्लताई हे आम्हाला अधिक जवळचं वाटतं, आणि म्हणून मी तसाच उच्चार करतो. गोवा कला अकादमीच्या स्थापनेपासून मी तिथं आहे, आणि माझ्या मागं असं म्हणण्यापेक्षा खंबीरपणे उभ्या राहिलेल्या प्रफुल्लताई. योगदान हा शब्द आपण खूप वेळा वापरतो, पण ते खरंखुरं योगदान काय असतं याचा अनुभव मी घेतलेला आहे. आणि या योगदानामध्ये कधी जे जे स्कूलमधले काही पुतळे इथून आमच्या आर्ट कॉलेजसाठी गोव्याला न्यायचे असतील, कधी विजया मेहतांच्या नाट्य विषयक कार्याचा गोव्याला परिचय करून द्यायचा असेल, कधी किशोरीताईंचं गाणं अरेंज करायचं असेल, कधी एम एफ हुसेन बेंद्रे यांच्यासारख्या दिग्गजांचा आर्टिस्ट कॅम्प घ्यायचा असेल, तर अगदी कोणत्याही संकोचा विना ज्यांना सांगावं असं व्यक्तिमत्व म्हणजे प्रफुल्लताई. आत्या आपल्यात नाही आहेत, परंतु ज्या ज्या वेळी कुठलंही काम कला अकादमीचं असलं असतं त्या त्या वेळी अगदी सहजपणे फोन करून अथवा ज्यांच्याशी संपर्क साधावा असं एकमेव व्यक्तिमत्व मुंबईत होत. आणि याचा पुरेपूर फायदा मला वाटतं कला अकादमी इतका दुसऱ्या कुणीही घेतला नसेल. त्यांच्या मोठेपणाचा, त्यांच्या एकूण व्यक्तिमत्वाचा. आज कला अकादमीची वास्तू सगळ्यांना माहिती आहे, पण त्या वास्तूच्या अगोदर, ती वास्तू निर्माण होण्या अगोदर कलाविषयक कार्य, कलाविषयक चळवळ गोव्यामध्ये जी उभी राहिली वेगवेगळ्या ठिकाणी, त्याचा थोडासा उल्लेख मी करतो. गोव्यात संगीत महाविद्यालय सुरू केलं आणि त्यावेळी मला माहिती आहे की यशवंत केरकर सारख्या तबला नवाजला, यशवंत तू चल गोया हे सांगण्याचा अधिकार वास्तविक त्यांच्या वयामध्ये फरक होता. यशवंत केरकर बुजुर्ग होते, परंतु सांगत असताना अगदी सहजपणानं. आणि संगीत महाविद्यालय जे सुरू झालं त्याचं नंतर खरंखुरं संगीत महाविद्यालय, आमच्याकडे संगीत क्लास राहिले कला अकादमीत, परंतु संगीत महाविद्यालय वेगळं, गोवा विद्यापीठाच्या कक्षेखाली वेगळं सुरू झालं. गोवा कॉलेज ऑफ आर्टची सुरुवात कशी झाली हे अतिशय म्हणजे मनोरंजक आहे सगळ्यांना. त्याचबरोबर सगळ्यांना प्रफुल्लताईंचं त्यांनी कसं काम केलेलं आहे त्याबद्दल, गोवा कॉलेज ऑफ आर्टच्या उभारणीसाठी हे सविस्तर सांगण्याजोगं असलं तरी मी एकच सांगू शकतो की हे कॉलेज उभं राहावं यासाठी अत्यंत काही वेळा प्रतिकूल अशा परिस्थितीमध्ये, म्हणजे महाराष्ट्र शासनातील बडे अधिकारी, मंत्री आणि टी के टोपेसाठे सारखे त्या काळचे व्हाईस चान्सलर मुंबई विद्यापीठाचे, कारण त्यावेळी आमच्याकडे गोवा विद्यापीठ नव्हतं, यांच्या सगळ्यांचं सहकार्य मिळवून ते कॉलेज सुरू झालं गोव्यामध्ये. आणि मला अभिमान अशासाठी की मी कला अकादमीत चीफ एक्झिक्युटिव्ह प्रिन्सिपल एक्झिक्युटिव्ह म्हणून जॉईन झालो त्यापासून, तेव्हापासून 6 महिन्यात ते कॉलेज सुरू झालेलं होतं. हे शक्य झालं फक्त प्रफुल्लताईमुळं. आणि अशा अनेक गोष्टी, अनेक कार्यक्रम, त्यांच्या संपर्कशील मनोवृत्तीचा फायदा पुनश्च एक बार सांगतो की कला अकादमी इतका आणखी कुणीही घेतला नसेल. आणि याच्यामधली एक गंमत सांगतो आणि मी संपवतो की चार्ल्स कोरिया सारखा जगप्रसिद्ध आर्किटेक्ट जे आमच्या त्या संकुलाचे, कला अकादमी संकुलाचे आर्किटेक्ट, त्यांना एखादी गोष्ट समजून सांगायची झाली अशा पद्धतीनं बोलणारे चार्ल्स प्रफुल्लताईंना सांगायचं, प्रफुल्लताई जरा, आणि मग ते त्यांना समजावून सांगण्याचं काम प्रफुल्लताईंनी केलं की दुसऱ्या वेळी चार्ल्स माझ्याकडे आल्यानंतर अतिशय वेगळ्या पद्धतीनं बोलायचे. के वैकुंठ सारख्या माणसानं ज्यावेळी एखादी हयगय केली कला अकादमीच्या कामात आणि ते प्रफुल्लताईंच्या कानावरती गेलं की त्यांना झापायचं काम, त्या झापण्याचा अनुभव मीही बराच घेतलेला आहे. पण त्याच्याबद्दल मला एक अभिमान आहे की या साऱ्या माझ्या घडण्यामागही कुठंतरी प्रफुल्लताई आहेत. आणि हे मी अतिशयोक्ती किंवा कुठल्याही यानं सांगत नाहीये, इथं आलो म्हणून सांगत नाही, हे मी मनापासून सांगतोय. आणि शेवटी माझ्या वैयक्तिक जीवनात प्रफुल्लताईंची ओळख मला वाटतं 13वी खेतवाडी असावी, म्हणजे खेतवाडी त्या ठिकाणी झाली ज्या ठिकाणी आमच्या भाषेत गंपू तात्या तात्या म्हणजे जितेंद्र अभिषेकी तिथं होते, आणि तिथं ओळख झाली. आणि त्यानंतर माझ्यासारख्या फाटक्या माणसाला त्या काली मधुमती सारख्या एका सिनेमाच्या प्रीमियरला घेऊन जाताना तुझा आहे तुझबाशी मधली अतिविशाल महिला पाहण्यासाठी मला नेत असताना गीतरामायणाचं पुस्तक सही करून मला देत असताना या माझ्या वैयक्तिक जीवनातल्या, आणि सौभाग्याची गोष्ट अशी आहे की या अनेक कलाकारांशी जो आज माझा अतिशय चांगला परिचय झाला, हा परिचय या परिचयाच्या माग प्रफुल्लताई आहेत. त्यांनीच. आणि मग ही माणसं के हेब्बर सारखे ग्रस्त आमच्या घरचे होऊन बसले, लता दीदी असतील, आणखी अशी अनेक माणसं अनेक व्यक्ती मोठमोठे कलाकार अल्लार खान आणि झाकीर हुसेन यांचा कार्यक्रम किंवा यांच्याबाबत ही सगळी माणसं